Glad to see you made it. Hope the trip wasn't too long. My name's Flora, and I'm the lead researcher here. Welcome to the Mangrove Restoration Project, part of the Build a Better World initiative, though we just call it the Project around here. Take a look around. A place like this should be teeming with mangroves, but, well, it isn't anymore. People have been tearing down the trees for years, making room for boats, businesses, factories, you name it. Mangroves provide homes for all sorts of creatures, like places in their weaving roots for fish to hide and treetops for monkeys to swing from. Without the mangroves, though, those animals started to disappear from the area. To make it worse, without the mangroves, there aren't enough plants to pull carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. CO2 contributes to climate change, and climate change makes it that much harder for mangroves to grow on their own. That's where we come in. Believe it or not, mangroves pull far more carbon dioxide from the atmosphere than most trees on land. In a healthy mangrove forest, the soil could have up to 4 times as much carbon stored in the sediment beneath them than you'd expect to find even in a rainforest. Considering the monumental amount of good that rainforests do for our environment, that is a significant contribution on the mangroves' parts. See, all plants need carbon dioxide to grow, so they pull what they need from the atmosphere and turn it into new branches and roots. However, whenever a tree dies or part of it, like the leaves, fall off, the dead plant matter decomposes and the carbon leaks back into the atmosphere. Mangroves, on the other hand, grow extensive, tangled root networks underwater. When a tree dies, the roots that are buried under the mud and silt decompose, and the carbon starts to seep through to the surface. The regular decomposition time could release all the dead plant's CO2 back into the world within a decade. But mangroves can store carbon for much, much longer. So for carbon to be stored within the mangrove's roots, it cannot just be an intact forest. It has to be a healthy one. Of the miles and miles of mangrove forests that covered our planet 200 years ago, only about half of that remains. It's up to us to preserve what we have and to restore what we have lost. The more mangroves we plant, the less dangerous climate change becomes, and the more animals will be able to return. When the animals return, then we'll start to see that broken-down villages revive as their inhabitants return to make a living from fishing, beekeeping, and other local economies. To make that happen, I'm trusting you with this. This is the State-of-the-Art Vegetation Implementation and Growth Stimulation System 2000, trademarked. Well, that's what the R&D department likes to call it. But boots-on-the-ground folks like you and me, we just call it the seed cannon. It makes planting trees and the like infinitely easier and helps bypass one of the greatest restrictions to plant growth. Time. Come on, I'll show you how it works. All right, see that patch of dirt? Aim the seed cannon at it and then use it like you would any other item or tool. I've already loaded a mangrove seed for you. Upon releasing the trigger, the seed will shoot out and the tree will pop up like a meerkat. Give it a whirl. You'll find different types of soil in different regions out there. Different species of mangrove trees will grow depending on the type of soil. Don't worry, the seed cannon will automatically plant the right seeds in the right places. Excellent! Good to see you're quick on the uptake. I don't have any more mangrove seeds on me, so you're going to have to gather them yourself. You see those little things hanging from that mangrove you just grew? Those propagules function as seeds. Normally, you would never be allowed to take these. It's against the law to harvest propagules in many parts of the world because of how few of these trees are left. But we have been given special permission. People are trusting us to collect these propagules so that we can plant and grow more of these weird, wonderful mangroves. Just make sure to be careful and respectful. Anyhow, I've got just one more thing to give you before you go running off to start saving the forest. Come with me back to the research station. Here. This monitor will let you measure the CO2 levels wherever you are. Just holding it in your hand and glancing at it will give you a rough idea of how much is in the air. If you see that needle pointing all the way to the right, then the area you're in desperately needs mangrove intervention to help clean the atmosphere. As another way to detect greenhouse gases, you can use the item more directly, like a camera, to actually see the clouds of CO2 around you. The darker the clouds, the denser the collection of carbon dioxide. By the time we're done, hopefully you'll only see pale puffs of the stuff left over. With that, you should be good to go. I know that's a lot of information to remember, so I wrote it all down in this book for you in case you forget. I'll be monitoring your progress from here, and you're always welcome to come by and check in. Do your best, and remember that planting these trees and cleaning the air doesn't just protect the world at large, but will also help the people and animals that want to call this place home. See ya!
your work with the seed cannon, the mangroves are coming back already. Healthy mangroves are the key to so many communities and animal survival. Among the gnarled roots, we're already starting to see wildlife like shrimp, rivulets, and the marvelous dugong returning. This is a great sign, so keep it up. Over and out.